guys, welcome back to my channel. So in my last video, I showed you the red wigglers that we're raising this bin to mess around with. So let's see what they're doing today. I have not looked at this. Oh boy, look at them. They're going nuts. Remember the chow that was there? It's gone. So they like the wet chow and they like the dry. So that's pretty good. But today we're going to start an experiment with them. See this bin here? It's a mortar bin. It's like for cement. We're going to put the red wigglers in here. And I'm going to feed half of it with rabbit manure. And let's see what's going to happen. And I'm going to put chow over here. So let's see what's going to happen. Worms do like rabbit manure. It's also a cold compost, which means that you don't need to pre-compost it to let it heat up and then cool down and then feed to your worms. You could just throw it right in. Now, don't do that with chicken manure. Don't do that with horse or cow. That stuff, you have to pre-compost it. But rabbit manure doesn't heat up like that. So that's why I like using it sometimes. But I haven't played around with the rabbit manure in a while, so I figured let's try again with these red wigglers and just see what happens. The bedding is coconut coir, shredded cardboard, shredded newspaper, the pine shavings I got yesterday, a little bit of dolomite lime and a little bit of azomite minerals, and then I dampened it down. It's damp, but I think I'm gonna dampen it just a little more, just to get them excited. Now the rabbit manure is soaking. Here it is soaking. So I am going to drain it and then I'll add it after I put the worms in. I'm going to let the worms go in and go down and do their thing. And then we're going to cover it with damp newspaper and we're going to see what's going to happen. So I still got these over here going. Set them up. You know, yesterday I did the acidity meter with them. Everything is good in these two nursery bins, so they're gonna get ready for the red wigglers. But let's see what's gonna happen with the manure thing. Red wigglers are really fun to play with. As you can see, they still have some of the damp chow in there, but they are all congregated here. Look at that. That is amazing. They are pretty warm. And if I'm quiet and you listen closely, you can hear kind of like a moisture sound. You hear that? So look, there's some on the side too, but they're mostly here. So I'm just gonna go like this. I'm going to take a chunk away from the chow. So we're going to just do this. I'm going to spread them out over here. And let's see what they're going to do. We are just going to see. I'm going to add a few more. As you can see, they have a tremendous appetite, so this is going to be fun. So let's give them a chance to go down. And these guys, I'm just going to probably throw it in one of my nurseries. Let me separate this. Look at them. They love that stuff. If you want some of my worm chow, just go on my website. If you click the link that says shop worms and supplies, you'll find it there. Oh, look, they're congregating in this corner, too. It's funny because this corner over here is kind of dry, and yet there's still a couple there. So, yeah, let's put them in the nursery. All right, I'm just going to grab a fistful and put it in this one. I'm going to grab a fistful and put it in this one. You know, sometimes I measure, sometimes I don't. It's funny because when I learned to cook, I didn't learn to cook by measuring. So my mom's like, just throw this here and throw that there. And basically that's how I learned. All right. So let's spread that out a little bit and let them go down. And oh, look, they landed on here. We're probably going to use this for that mortar bin. Let's let them go down. This chow I found in that other bin, I'm just going to leave on the surface here. If you bury that, most likely your bin will heat up. So that's why I always recommend surface feeding. And I have buried it, and it has heated up on me. But you don't want to do that unless, you know, you're going to be close to do an experiment and to rescue them if you have to. But why go through all that? So I just leave it on the surface. Let's let them go down. All right. I'll come back when they disappear. So I'm feeding this one chow and that one chow. I'm going to spray the surface with my special liquid. And we're going to cover that with wet newspaper and we'll be ready to go. So these guys here, they're still on their way down. That little mountain is working at it. And we're just going to give them a chance. All right, well, here's the poop. So we're going to put it on this half of the bin. Doesn't really smell like anything. It smells like, I don't know, like a farm. Which kind of smells like poop, I guess. All right, so we're going to leave that there. And the next half, we're going to do the chow. Over here, and let's do the chow. All right, we're gonna spray it and let's see what they're gonna do. Because the chow, they'll eat it faster if you spray it down. Just spread the whole thing. All right, now we're gonna put newspaper on this and then I'm gonna go have lunch. And in a little while, I'm going to come back and just look and then see what happens. And overnight, I don't know. What are your predictions? Tell me below. So I wet them down and I cover them in plastic. One of the plastic pieces I cut a little too short. That's all right. So let's put the thermometer in there. And let's see what it's like. Maybe I should do it like this. Well, let's do it this way. What is that? 70 degrees Fahrenheit. You can see that, right? Okay. So we're going to keep checking the temperature on this and see if it rises. And, let's see what it's going to do. Okay, so I poked a hole in the plastic and I stuck it in there. And as you can see, it is 71 in there. So I'm going to leave that and then we're going to see what's going to happen. It's also pointing towards the manure side. I didn't do that on purpose, honestly. I just poked a hole and it just happened to be there. So let's just see what this is going to do. So there we go. The manure thing is going. With the worm chow on the half. These guys are covered. I didn't wet that enough, but I will when I come back. I just wanted to cover them so the bedding doesn't dry out. But remember, I got that vent up there. It can dry things out. So let's see what's gonna happen with this. Good morning, guys. It's the next morning. I love when I come in here and I smell wood shavings. You know what, guys? I love the smell of wood. All right, let's see what the temp's at. It's holding steady at 74. So I haven't looked at them. I just walked in here and I just turned you on. So let's see what Let's see what they're doing. Oh boy. Oh, look at them. You know, I can't tell. Do they like the manure more or do they like the chow more? What do you all think? I think it's even. Some prefer that and some prefer that. You know what? It doesn't smell like I thought it would. Well, they like it. Eventually, when I build windrows outside, I'm going to feed my worms a lot of manure because we live around a lot of farms, like a lot of them, and there's manure everywhere. Joe's going to buy me a trailer and a hitch for my car. These guys are still eating so that I could go pick it up. If I could get the farmer to, like, you know, do that with me. I'm sure they will. They like to get rid of their poop. These guys are all doing fine. Let's see here. There they are, growing up. It's funny how the minute they see the light. So Joe and I have been talking about the light in here. And we keep these lights on all night, all day. They never shut off because, you know, I'm scared that the worms are going to run. So we're thinking that maybe down here along every shelf, do a strip of lights. Those lights that you see along the edges of decks and things. And around the whole room, you know, that should be enough to keep them contained and keep them, you know, staying in there. So we've been talking about that. So I hope you like this video. I hope you're excited to follow this experiment with me and see what's gonna happen. Hopefully it'll be good. I know it'll be good. It'll be all right. And if something happens, then I'll take drastic measures like I always do. But you know, I like the challenge. So it's exciting to see what's gonna happen with these guys. So anyway, like and subscribe, keep watching. Thank you to all my new subscribers. You guys are so sweet. I love you all. See you next time.